Okay, in this video, what I want to talk about is how we calculate out area when we're given diameter and vice versa. And so this is really important for a fluid power technician to understand, because oftentimes out in the field, the area of a cylinder piston is not given, only the diameter of the piston. So if you look at this, piston rod here, okay, and you look at the piston right here, what the manufacturer is going to give you is the diameter of this piston. They're not typically going to give you the area of the piston. And so it's your job to be able to calculate out what the area of this circle is based off of that value, the number that they give you. And that number comes from the model number, and then you use the manual to figure out what that diameter is. So, once you have the diameter, it's important for you to be able to calculate out the area. And the math isn't very tricky here, but I want to go over it real quick with you. And so, the way that I like to think about it is this. So if I draw a square, a perfect square, which this will not be perfect, but it'll be good enough for this video. So I have a square here. And let's say this square is 5 inches by 5 inches, okay? Now, if I want to know the area of this, I just take 5 and I square it. Pretty simple. So, then that would give me the area. So 5 times 5, 25 inches squared. That's the area of this. But how do I do it if it's a circle, which all cylinders are? I know there's a couple oval cylinders out there used in pneumatics, but for hydraulics, all cylinders that I've ever seen are a circle. So I take that circle, and let's say the diameter of this from here to here was 5 inches, okay? And I wanted to calculate out what the area is. So this is how I imagine it. So what you do is, if I were to draw a perfect circle inside of that square, okay? So I have a circle in here that is perfectly centered on a square that has the exact same diameter. So that circle would take up 78.54% of that square. That's how much room it would take up. So extracting that information, if I want to be able to calculate out the area of a circle when I'm only given diameter, the way that I do it, and the way this is often done by fluid power technicians, is you would take 5 squared times 0.7854, and that would give you the area of the circle in square inches. So if you want to break this formula down, what you would end up doing is taking 25 times 0.7854, so 25 times 0.7854, and you would get about 19.6 inches squared. So that is the area of a circle that has a 5-inch diameter. Now, there are other ways you can do it. If you have the radius, you can take the radius squared times pi. There are a lot of different ways to do this. But since manufacturers typically give you the diameter of the circle, not the area and not the radius, this I have found to be the most precise way to do it. And how I remember this, 0.7854, is if you look at your calculator and you look at the upper left hand corner, you just make a square going clockwise. So 7854. Okay? So now let's reverse that and let's look at it from the standpoint of you've calculated out the area you have to have from your cylinder, and you need to then calculate out what the diameter of the cylinder needs to be. And so, for example, we've taken our fluid power circle, F over P times A, and based upon the pressure that's available and the force that we need to move, we have an area need of 50 inches squared. So this is the area we need. All right, how do I extract the diameter from that? To calculate out the diameter when the area is known, the needed area is known, the formula for that is just you take diameter equals the square root of the area over 0.7854. Okay, and so when you do this, you've basically just done some math magic on your original formula of diameter squared times 0.7854. You've come out with this. So we'll get our calculators out, and depending on your calculator will depend on when you have to apply the square root key. But in this one, we go ahead, hit the square root key, take the area, which is 50, divide that by 0.7854, and that equals roughly 7.98, okay? So we would just go ahead and round that up to an 8-inch diameter. And so when you'd go to order this cylinder or look for the cylinder, you would want to look for a diameter of 8 inches. Okay, so I hope this helped kind of settle out some of the confusion. There are a couple of other different ways to do this when you have radius and things like that, but I find this to be the most direct way to calculate out going from diameter to area and area to diameter, which I have found to be a really useful tool for all hydraulic and pneumatic technicians to understand. Hope this helped. Thanks.